Smith in a 1978 C10 called Solid. He won the championship here at Summernats 18. He came second at Summernats 19. His son was out here yesterday, a square body called Piggy. In the passenger seat is Nick from Tarsia Tyres, and he is having a blast. I can't see through the smoke. Does anyone know if he's okay down there?
Well, the noise. I can't hear the noise. We're going to have a look at the replay here, though. It's quite a bit of speed. He took a big car to throw that much speed into the burnout pad, too. Spins around, gets on the anchors there. The car manages to come back in the same direction. You can get caught in the smoke sometimes when it does that, but it looks like there's a nice alignment there so you can see what's going on. You can hear the RPM just building throughout that burnout. Unfortunately, it is stopped in the middle of our rod shop burnout pad at the moment, and we are hoping he can fire that big block back up.
Now, Danny did say to me, hey, Lara, if you're going to give a shout-out, can you give a shout-out to my wife, Judy? Make sure she knows how much I love her, because I get to come here to Summernats 36. And right now, you wish you had a KE30, don't you? Because they're much lighter to push off the pad.
Come on, cheer on Danny Smith.
Oh, Nick, the sponsor from Tarsia Tyres, putting in his weight as well. We don't want that other thing to come out here.
He'd be wishing that those tyres had air in them, I reckon, about now. Because it's...
Nick, you got any tyres?
Onya that are inflated, just a rattle gun.
Whack one under.
Just do it.
We're not going to have that.
Do
it. Horrible.
Call the Triton.
No.
Call the Triton.
No, we're in the driver's seat. We're good. We're golden. Big Chevys don't let you down, do they?
I say nothing.
I did have one. It was a very abusive relationship. Every time I looked at it, my wallet cried.
Yes, I've had good luck with big block Chevs, but I have. Not everybody.
There it is.
I probably wasn't pushing him to the...
540 cubic inches of pain right there. The Triton of Doom is on the pad. I really wish we didn't need the Triton.
We'll just get a new car next year.
Yeah, sure.
It will still be a Doom vehicle.
I'm trying to work out what has an equal amount of Doom to it as a Triton.
Can we dress it up like a Mad Max car?
Great Wall of Doom could work.
No, it's... Probably would, actually. It would keep working. They're pretty simple cars. They keep working. Great to see so many people here enjoying Street Machine Summer 36 with all of us, not just as the entrants, but also everybody in the crowd. We all make this up. Oh, yeah, I know. You're all looking at the start line because Gus Boy is lined up. This is another impressive car. Craig Ingold, he's done plenty of burnouts there. He changes up the rat rod style look on the front of that quite often. We have seen the machine guns on it, you know, with all the artillery and everything. Now we've got the letterbox back on there.
Well, he's going to send it. You need a letterbox if you're going to send it.
Exactly. Of course, twin turbo LS setup. He does quite a few burnouts up and down the East Coast part of the time, militia.
And he's painted this LS using Caterpillar paint. He wants to bring through that Caterpillar vibe. Sharia sitting in the driver's seat. They're all the way from Wollongong this weekend. 37 Chevy sitting on a Hilux chassis. They are going to have some fun out there.
His signature is get the donut done early in the shoot.
Yeah.
That's a signature move from him here at Summernats. We've seen it from a few cars. Not everybody can do it. And we don't see a lot of the turbo cars holding on. Let's make some noise for Craig Ingold now. In Gus Boy as he fires up. The final words of encouragement from the man himself on the start line. And now it's all in the hands, waiting for the green light. like the tyres are going on the back of Gus Boy for Craig Ingold. Cheer, cheer, cheer here at Summonats. Always puts on a great display in that car, and you can hear that just on plenty of boost as well.
He sent it. That little mailbox out the front did its job.
There,
he had
there
a great
is a letter
time.
In it right now. Hopefully the letter says you've made the top 50. Hopefully.
Hey, Canberra, we have got a local for you down here. Connor is in Feedham. His mate Tom is sitting in the passenger seat. He is going to have a brilliant time out there in this big blue Commodore.
BG engines on the rocket covers. We've seen quite a few of those engine combinations here this weekend. Time to party back at the rod shop pad. The noise has stopped here. What have we got? Looks like air in the tyre on the driver's side. Fire's back up though. You know what we want to see, don't you? The tyres must be gone. The red flags, will they go down? All the officials will check everything out, make sure everything is A-OK before they let them finish these tyres off. Hopefully it's all good. The Freedom VT of Easy Life Automotive here, right here in the ACT. Oh, looks like our fire crew getting right on this. Looks like we're going to have a bit more of a check underneath the car as well. There's things under there like the boots on the steering column and things like that. And the tie rod ends, they like to get a little bit warm. Sometimes that causes a little bit of heat under there, things to melt. And so there's not really anything happening under the car, any fluid or anything like that. It's just the amount of heat and what's going through there. Gets a little bit hot.
But we've got amazing staff, don't we? Like, whoa, they're right there on the job.
But what we don't have is that's not amazing is the Triton of Doom. That is so unfortunate there. Very, very unfortunate. But that means we will get this car off. And we will get on with our next burnout engine. Quick clean up there while we have this car stopped on the track. Steve Cerrone looks like he's up next. And look, they've got a couple of cars there. I know they'll be looking at drag, challenge. This guy's been a drifter as well. He's done a fair bit of stuff. I know they've got quite a few cars on the build if you follow them on social media. But the good old EJ Holden sedan.
From Maury, Stephen, and in the passenger seat is Brian. They are, you know, they're lads that want to have fun out here.
Steve does like to have a lot of fun. It generally involves driving vehicles. I don't think it matters whether it's burnout, dragging, drifting. I think it's just about anything that he can get behind the wheel of, to be quite honest. It does it with family too, building a lot of these vehicles. It's angry too. It sounds angry. It looks like 408 cubes of Chevy power. Goodness between the chassis rails. You're not often seeing an EJ burnout car. Yeah, 408 cubes of balance, yes. It's time. Can you use some of that drifting? Can you put it to work here on the Rod Shop Burnout Pad? Steve Cerrone. gets the job done. Steve Cerrone. And drives off the pad. That is a gorgeous cut. You won't see too many EJs getting around full stop, let alone bringing around on the burnout pad. Let's have a look at the replays he took off. So much bloke took a fair bit of speed, and I said those drifting abilities have come into style here. Look at it, full 360, turns around. Car just doesn't have a quite bit of, you know, enough momentum there. You see the body roll comes back the opposite direction. But we're not mucking around here. We've got plenty of cars here through this afternoon here in the Burnout Championship qualifying. Nathan Robinson now coming the LS down, Hot Rodeo.
Nathan down there in Rowdy. This skid was a tribute to his Nana and Papa, who also always supported him. But can I just point out, this man has a mullet that is worthy of the mullet comp.
It's worthy.
Oh, it is beautiful.
In the wind. Imagine it going around as he tipped it in. Have a look at the replay. And I want to see if it flows around as he goes through and gets the first donut done. Here we go. Oh, it's almost long enough to come out the window.
That LS1 has never been tested. Didn't even do skid row this weekend. This is its first time being put under pressure, and it held up.
It's maiden thrashing.
It's maiden thrashing.
Oof.
Oh, with the mullet, with his wind in his mullet. It's lovely.
He epitomises what Summonats is.
He's like the poster child
for
Summonats.
I like it.
It is gorgeous. Get Him Off is coming up the start line next. So, and guess what it is?
It's one of your passions in life, one of your soft spots, one of your... it's a car that really invigorates you.
Look, I was having a chat to Jason down there and his passenger, Nick, and he said, yeah, fresh paint job, crashed it in Darwin, had a good touch-up, and I said, don't you dare crash it today.
Well, they fixed that and turned it around to go to a local burnout comp down there in Wagga in about 3 or 4 weeks.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it wasn't quite right, so then they pulled it apart again, giving it a full once-over, I suppose. They got just... it was a fairly hard hit there in Darwin as well. It wasn't a little tap, like a little wall love tap. It was harsh.
He went sign hunting in a big way.
Yeah, it's a little bit different from the wall there. It's a bit chamfered off, so it's sort of... It got a little bit airborne, but it's, look.
Well, I do love my tunners. I love a HQ tunner. This is a beautiful example of that. So I'm hoping he takes care of it out there. Jason McEnany is going to be up at the start line soon. We're just waiting for our pad staff to give us a green flag and tell Matty Abood to bring him up.
Great to have everyone here at the Street Machine Summit. That's 36. So much going on. Don't forget Skid Row down the back there. Well, that's not going to stop. I can tell you that is going to go on for as long as they're allowed to go down Skid Row. Cars will be going down there. We've got the eBay Australia Drift Pavilion up behind us as well, which is through the main gate entry up there. It's there for so many years now. I'm trying to think back how far. Probably six or seven years it's been up there. And the Drift Cadet boys running that one. If you want to get a ride in a Drift Cadet, you can go up and pay for that. Sign your little indemnity and go and have some fun in the passenger seat of a drift car. Many different cars to choose from, depending on what you like, whether it's a Holden Ute or whether it's a Toyota 86.
Tell you what, I'm a little sad I missed out on some of the action there over in the Haltech Hero, Horsepower Heroes stand over there with the dyno, an RB30 pulling out 2,500 ponies.
And not just an RB30, a Matuk's RB30. Oh, and if you've ever gone to drag racing and ever understand what that means, is he is, you know... He built some incredible RBs, that's it. He built some very, very incredible RBs.
This is twice now we've seen a six-cylinder tap out over the 2000 mark.
It's pretty common with drag racing. Mm. We don't see them all here at Summonats, but look, it's not the Barra doing it. We do have the billet Barras out there now. The standard Barra blocks seem to be cracking all at the same spot after 2000 horsepower. So
didn't we have a lady from WA with an XR6 turbo?
From Victoria.
Victoria,
2200.
Sorry.
Okay, yeah. Pesos, that was a few years ago now. Oh, here we go. The Greys are out. Speaking of legends of Summonats, let's bring him out from the other end. Now we know what's going on here. Yes. Cheer him on. USA 502. Not sure who's in the wheel. We don't care. It's a Grey. Can he do it? Can they do it? It's close.
Peter Gray is a Hall of Famer for a reason.
I tell you what, the arm in the passenger seat looks super familiar to me. It looks super familiar. Make a bit of noise, ladies and gentlemen, all the way from the USA. Heard from Hoonigan riding shotgun in the Greys Camaro. Bit of USA royalty over there in a USA 502.
What a lucky, lucky passenger. Give it up, folks. Give them some love down there. That Camaro is always stunning, and we love seeing it come out to do exhibition skits here at Summonats on the Rod Shop pad.
Yeah, no, it's the passenger side. Come on. Oh, it's Hurt getting out. Come on, Hurt. The crowd want to see you. I know you've been touring around. We might have to. Look, give him a wave. Yeah, he's got the finger out. Wave of the crowd down there. Great to see Zach and Hurt from Hoonigan getting around this weekend at the Summonats 36. You can see them doing a fair bit on Thursday, going through the City Cruise cars and getting around. A little bit coolant coming out of the good old USA 502. It's been one of the most reliable burnout cars here. We've seen it do demonstrations, then back it up in competition. It's incredible what Peter and Debbie Gray have done throughout their burnout career. And I don't actually think they've ever missed a Summonats.
If you talk about relationship goals, that's pretty high on my list. Imagine being able to share a Camaro with the other half and go out there and do that.
Yes.
Both of you do it to the same standard where we sit here and go, I don't know who's driving. They're both very good. Right now, though, we have got Jason McEnany coming up to the start line in a one-tonner. As we said, he's had a little bit of issues in the past, but he is going to have a brilliant time out here with a brand new paint job. Get him off.
Absolutely loving it here at Summon House. Look at this. Limmy fingers all the way down for Jason McInerney in Get 'Em Off.
Thank you, Jason, for looking after that beautiful one, Tana, making sure she stayed nice and clear of all the hard bits.
Oh, let's have a look at the replay. Look at the speed and the intensity of the tip in. 2.360s as he went around there. Sets himself up for the exit shoot as well. Drove it in there nicely. Still with speed. That's what took me in that burnout. How much speed he kept going down the exit shoot. You don't want too much, otherwise you can over-rotate there in the exit shoot and get yourself in a little bit of mischief.
We've got Phoenix down on the start line right now. Matt is in the driver's seat. Wife Jess is in the passenger seat. They're from Newcastle. Might be getting a bit scary out there. There's an awful lot of smoke. This is their first time on the pad at Summonats. They built this LS at home in the garage. Phoenix looking the business though. Are we just lost?
Ooh, there's a lot of coloured smoke inside that car. Very hard to see, but are we? Have we got drive? Yes, we do.
Give it up for Matthew McCabe. First time on the pad at Summonats in Phoenix.
The crowd really like it though. Look at them. They are going off here at the Rod Shop Burnout Pad here today. Biggest crowd we've ever seen, I reckon, here at the Burnout Pad. Biggest crowd I can remember seeing here. The most noisy crowd too.
Second year that we have sold out on a Saturday. This is fantastic. I reckon Matt and Jess are going to be pretty tickled with that. Apparently their 12-year-old daughter does all the oil changes on that car and services. The whole family gets involved.
My daughter needs to step up her game then.
Yeah. What are you doing as a father?
I know. Not teaching her to change oil
But then again,
enough.
You're not down on the pad yet either.
No, but she could do it at home.
Yes, she could. She could. All righty, we've got ourselves another ratty-looking beast here. Mick Haywood is coming up next.
Not only to see a Studebaker like this come out on the Burnout Pad 2, of course, twin-turbo LS.
Of course.
Not huge turbos, just little ones. It's very similar to the Gus Boy, I reckon, with the setup there. It's time, though. Let's see if we can smash another couple of sets of tyres.
You've gone quiet. I can't hear the little... Oh,
well,
no, he's
it's
making
driving
his
off.
Way
That's
off.
What we like. But did we see the tyres? We could not see from the smoke here up from our commentary box. Let's have a look at the replay, though. Plenty of smoke to kick things off, though. And the Studebaker, it was on song at this point. Nice speed as he headed in. Moved over to the right-hand side of the pad. Gave himself plenty of room. Lots of smoke, really, isn't he? He's got stuck there. The car slows down. The smoke caught up to him.
We need to move the wind so that we're not downwind. We never see enough. Tista One, big crewman coming up on the start line right now.
Brendan Stapleton. And now our crew over to Tisda One very, very quickly. Checking something out here on the Rod Shop Burnout Pad. Hopefully. We have seen him do a few burnouts here at Summonats. If I remember correctly, we might have seen him one of the years where we couldn't. We had a different contingency of our wildcard shooter. He might have been in that, actually, in Tisda One.
Passenger said, no, I'm going to get help.
Not often we see the crewmans in the burnout comp. Very, very long vehicle.
You know who has a nice crewman and uses it to tow their vehicle everywhere? It's even got a gooseneck hitch in it. Is Mark Hayes and Carolyn Hayes over there in Maguire's Pavilion towing around their gorgeous collection of Taranas. Love to see that crewman down here on the Burnout Pad. We could have a crewman comp.
Possibly. I've seen a couple of crewmans now in the burnout competitions. But yeah, they are an extended. They're longer than a statesman as well. So they're very, very big cars.
Yeah. I get the feeling we're okay.
Yes, it's all been checked over. Now, what is the go? Our officials are going to make their way off the pad. Do the flags go from red to green? That's the question. Who wants to see him finish the tyres up? Come on. It's got war speed on the back. You know the engines. Still, it's not going to give up until those tyres are gone.
Brendan Stapleton. He's in the big crewman down there. Plenty of artwork on that car. Now, guys in high vis, just making sure it is all safe. Passenger getting back in. That's a good sign, right?
Something obviously caught the attention of our volunteers. Brought that to a stop. Oh, it's all over though. Give it up for Brendan Stapleton, ladies and gentlemen. Tis the one. It's always a joyous moment out there in the middle of Paddington. Have you ever seen an angry burnout driver out there?
I've seen sad.
I've seen emotional.
Yes.
Never angry.
No. They're always either relieved, a little bit sad, but mostly just happy. I can feel the bromance off for a lot of them.
Yes.
It's a lot of hugging, a lot of high-fiving, a lot of, yeah, we're happy people.
Oh, there's so much going on to dissect here at the Street Machine Summonats, and it looks like maybe a little bit of coolant just left on there for us to be cleaned up. And we'll drive very quickly. We're out there at lunchtime in the sun. I was down there doing the ball draw. And look, slip, slop, slap, if you're out there, make sure you've got your sunscreen on. It is available around the place. Some of you out there getting your suns out, guns out, tans. You can see that up there in the grandstands. That's
a sign of your
youth.
That's
okay.
I don't do that anymore. Hey, if you've got the Summonats app, you'll see a notification just came through. That's pretty exciting. Wonder what's happening in the big world of Summonats right now. Who we got on the line? Just six?
Mark Ansaldi used to have a Barra Ute, but now he's gone into the EL Falcon. Of course, it's got to be Barra Power, though. It is just six. Just six, Mark Ansaldi. Big pop of the tyres there.
I think it did it proud.
It did it proud. Come on, there's got to be some six of the Ford fans out there. You're either a Barra fan or you're not, I think, when it comes to the Ford people.
Well, you can't be a six-cylinder.
The car either says not Barra or it doesn't. That's how it goes. The replay shows that it was still popping out a fair bit of smoke. He got through a couple of gears there, which really needed the wheel speed up with the coloured tyres to make that much smoke. He won't go away from the six-cylinders, though. That's what it is. Another Ford coming out.
This meltdown.
Oh, yeah, it sounds like he's got a couple more cylinders hanging off there. It's going to be Jennifer Lashbrook.
Jennifer Lashbrook. She is doing the ladies proud out there with Meltdown. Lemmy fingers for days.
Oh, it sounded like an LS. It had the feel of an LS. It was an LS transplanted Falcon.
I gotta say, I am super impressed by the sun consciousness of our crowd out there. It's a sea of sombreros out on one side of the pad. My 80XD is out here for the wild cards. He is back once more, Pete Thompson.
Well, time to rev the small block Ford. Thompson, my 80XD. The Ford fans must be absolutely loving that 289 cubes of screaming small block Ford.
That's why he had a wildcard ticket. He is obviously in the big leagues. Fantastic to see you here at the Summonats 36 Burnout Championship Eliminations. We've got a lineup of cars.
Look at the donut, though, up on the replay there. How quick he turned that car around for an XD.
It's beautiful, beautiful work
didn't
there.
Didn't know how to get off the accelerator, Pete, though. He just kept the RPM all the way up there. I mean, it's probably a trade-off there where you go small cubes. He used to have a little bit bigger cubes with a blower on it. He said, nah, I want to hear RPM. I want to stand out. That's why I want to be winning, and he's done that all over the East Coast.
Our amazing pad staff are down there. Make sure it's nice and safe. Get rid of all the chunky bits that Pete left behind. Of course, if you need to stretch your legs, Drift Academy is keeping on up there in the eBay shed. We've also got the Dino Horsepower Heroes. We've got Maguire's Pavilion, the Rare Spares Pavilion, the Lawnmower Racing's happening in the main arena, and the smoke cloud continues over on Skid Row. So much to see and do. We've got plenty more Burnout Championship eliminations ahead for you today. 5 o'clock, the top 10 Masters Finals go through, and then we're heading across the main arena at 6. Right now, though, the naturally aspirated king.
I'm having a guess. It's the second entrant number.
Well, we did see it yesterday, yes. So I think this is our second driver, Isaiah DePiazza.
We're going to go. It's one or the other.
Sure.
The NA King, Price Engines on the rocker covers. Here we go.
Sayer there, doing a fantastic effort in the NA King.
If you're going to be the NA King, you've got to have cubes. 540 of them as they thudded down the rod shop burnout pad. You could really hear it when they took off with that exhaust note. You can tell a big block, it really stands out just when you're standing behind it and the force of the exhaust comes out. Green flag still on our burnout track here at Street Machine Summonats, and it's Illu about to come out. So it's by ABC Tyres. Got the Mad Nats party sticker on it. Gives it a rev to clear the throat. Anthony Manning.
Anthony Manning, it'll do. It'll do, Dobby, it'll do.
It'll do, pig, it'll do.
Fantastic, we are here for the Burnout Championship eliminations. Rev Rat making his way up to the start line. We've still got plenty of replay up on the big screen if you're thinking, I want more of Anthony Manning's action. But right now though, Rev Rat, Jacob Vogels at the wheel. Still got a lot of cars lined up down there. We've got about 2 more hours of Burnout Championship eliminations for you this afternoon.
Thank you.
Jacob Vogels. Give him some love. Look at the limmy fingers out there. They are just going nuts. Are they worn out yet? Can you pull a limmy finger?
You can't. Can you pull a limmy finger? I hope not.
I don't want to pull a finger at all.
You never know.
That looks like a lot of rubber they're picking up out of the middle of that pad. Is that a hole?
Think about this. That almost looked clean when we started. We know it's never clean after summer. That's the year after. But it's been weathered. It's been sweat.
We washed it on Thursday.
It get washed a lot. The sweeper comes out. Like all that stuff after summer that's and leading up to it. It is a fresh surface now. And you can actually almost see grooves in the rubber out there. Chubba now coming out to the start line here.
It's a tonner.
And it's pink. Is it pink?
I don't care if it's pink. I just care that it's a tonner. And it's a Holden tonner. We'll take it. Shane Wood.
One tie they both got. I don't know. It's on a lean.
No.
Come on, Chubba.
Shane Wood limping off the pad with three tires.
I reckon the temperature gauge has gone past hot.
Yes.
To extremely ready to be off the pad.
Yes. Coloured smoke. Interesting choice out there this afternoon. A lot of people are choosing the big coloured smokes. Not sure it's always working in their favour. It does look impressive. We have got something very impressive coming up the start line right now. If anyone out there is tech savvy and can record the sound of this beautiful big Camaro and turn it into an alarm clock noise for me to wake up to in the morning, I would be forever grateful. Dragon Steve Titcomb is down here right now. We had a couple of Camaros here this week. I think this is number 3 or 4 that we've seen.
And why would we have 589 cubes of big block to assault the burnout pad?
Steve Titcomb, Dragon, I love this car. Oh, actually, now I've decided I want my alarm to be slightly different.
Oh, he came, he left, and he just entertained the crowd. I can't wait for this replay. Look at the speed there. Went opposite down, tipping as well in such a big car. That's a big risk. But you got to risk if you want to try and impress the judges and make it through to just the final 50 cars in our Burnout Championships. Over 500 cars are qualifying. We need to get it down to just 50.
Well, 500 cars are in the elimination. We've got yet another SS Commodore up right now for you. Justin Wesley at the wheel. Red flags are out. Justin Wesley and Wild Boy, the SS Commodore. Plenty of smoke as he left the pad down there. Fantastic to see. You are watching the Street Machine Summonats 36 Burnout Championship Eliminations. We are going through to 5 o'clock with these. We're about 500 cars to push through to pick our top 50, which will come back for the finals tomorrow. You'll be staggered to know we have a Commodore on the start line. Flynn Turchett, and have some. Flynn Turchett, have some. He had some, didn't he?
Leave on Limiter. That's what he should be calling himself. Leave on Limiter. Because that's exactly what he did in the VT Calais.
Which was excellent, because I was worried our limmy fingers down there might get rested.
Have some.
Tired.
You have some Limiter, that's for sure. Well, here we go. Look at the amount of smoke he made on the replay as well. They were excited to be here at Summonats so much as they threw it in.
On tick, lining up down there, making a bit of noise.
Billy Seaton's back from his wild card journey. Didn't make it through, but he's back in the Burnout Championships. Time to get that Warspeed LS fired up. He's the madman behind the wheel, Billy Seaton, in on tick.
Billy, bad boy Billy, where are you in that smoke? We can't hear you in on tick. Billy Seaton on tick. I think he's left the pad down there. We've got red flags. There's a lot of smoke. I can't see much. Oh, no, we haven't. We have actually decided to go collecting signs. Billy, why would you do that? Grabs reverse, pulls it up. Look on the big screen if you're like me and can't see what's happening down the other end there. Now he's making his way off the pad, and he looks like he's got an awful lot of rubber underneath that back end. What do you reckon, Sean?
Looks like quite a bit intact, but this crowd still appreciate a beautiful car and a skilled driver when they see it. Maybe not quite up to his own standards there.
Yeah, I think Billy's going to be down Skid Row, thrashing and punishing on tick. Another regular here at the Summonads Burnout Pad is Filth V. He's going to be coming up to the start line right now for us. As soon as those track staff tell us it's all clear. Kyle Priestley is the man at the wheel. Filth V, the big wagon, he is gonna send it. Look at the action happening in this engine bay. He could not jam another thing in there if he tried. Summonats 36.
A lot of smoke there from Kyle Priestley. Hard to see anything from any angle.
Filth V. Now that car we did, we're just having a chat. A few years ago, I think it was 2019, he actually ran back over the entry, the start line, and ended up going back home like a runaway pony that just didn't want to play the game with a mongrel kid on it. Right now, we have got yet another little Corolla. Is it a Corolla? I think we're looking at a Corolla K30-ish. Look at that replay up there at Kyle Priestley. Lee Schumacher, Pro 73Q. I don't really think that's his emblem. Folks, little bit of confusion. Maddie Cab tells me Joel Sykes is behind the wheel there, and that was an impressive drive. Might be double entered. Not sure. We live in the dark in the commentary tower. It's a beautiful place. We have got ourselves another Gemini. Geminis are coming through. Wog job. I can even read this number plate. It's fantastic. Well written. Four-door Gemini. I think it's about a fifth or sixth this morning. Sean.
Memorable plate, memorable number, 100.
I do love me some Wogs. Wogs are fantastic people. I love them around the racetrack. They build beautiful cars. In fact, I'm pretty sure it was a Wog building that RB30. Jake Calafiore.
Sounds like Jake might be in a spot of bother here. What can we see up on the big screen? Things are slowing down indeed. Not what he would like to be seeing.
No, but look, it's a Gemini. Rare spares. They proudly support us. They're going to support him as well. Jake will be able to find whatever he needs for the Gemini up there, I'm sure. Oh, look at the exhaust on the Wog Job. That is massive. All right, I have a... Oh, I'm going to do the voice, Maddie. I'm going to do the voice, but I don't want to do the voice because I don't want to see it out here. I think that Jake can pull it together. I think Jake can get the Gemini off the pad under its own steam. I have faith. Oh, no, it's hardcore. This is not the Triton of Doom. No.
What do we call this?
Oh, it's the tilt tray of doom. It's far, far worse. Oh, no. You know what that means? That means it's not towable. That means that she just does not want wheels to turn at all. We're going to cut to a bit of an ad break for you, folks. Please take this moment to visit the bathrooms, recharge your drinks and beverages and food. We'll be back very, very shortly with more Burnout Championship eliminations.
We hope you're enjoying your Summonats so far. Come see myself, Rory and the crew down at our Tough Streeters marquee. We've got all the giveaway cars there and you can sign up for a membership as little as $5 a week. Scan all the QR codes you see. I'll see you on Skid Row.
Whether you're building a street machine or a race car, Aeroflow Performance has a solution for you. Our ever-increasing range features boosted turbocharger systems, Bosch Motorsport products, X-Pro electrical systems, hoses and fittings, bang shift shifters, differential parts, and fabrication components. You can see it all on aeroflowperformance.com.
Spares has over 50,000 product lines and releases over 500 new products every year. Your local Rare Spares distributor has what you need when you need it. And as the only restoration company officially backed by Holden and Ford, we take our part in your project very seriously. Rare Spares, more than just a part in your project.
Castlemaine Road Shop is back at Summonats. Located on Tuff Street, check out the massive range of merchandise from t-shirts, hats, hoodies and beanies.
Warbird, mad.
See the updated Ferrari-powered Real Deal Torana and the iconic Warbird XP Falcon on display. Pay us a visit on Tuff Street and shop online at rodshop.com.au.
Benekas, meant to skid. Sean, we're on. Car number 290, meant to skid, is on the start line. Any minute now, Josh is going to tell me. Toby Howe is at the wheel. Look at this. We're like a well-oiled machine up here. And we've got a Commodore down there with Matty Abu. This is fantastic. Toby at the wheel, meant to skid. You ready, Sean?
He's made a big call on the plates. Let's go.
Yeah, no, I think everyone expressed how I felt right then. Well done. Well done. How did you all know that? Toby, I feel for you, man. I feel for you. Can we start her anyway?
Come on, Tobes.
I think maybe if the crowd gave a little encouragement.
Just a little bit?
Just a little bit. Maybe we could just cheer Mentiskid back into action, or maybe we push her back. Oh, no, no, we're getting staff there saying, don't do that. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Fantastic, though. We have the best pad staff anywhere on the planet, I believe, and they are right on there. They're making sure not only is Toby okay, but the car is... Oh, my gosh. Straight up, it's the Triton of Doom.
Oh, dear.
We didn't even get to the end of the entry shoot. Poor Toby. How awkward, though. You're sitting in the driver's seat and everyone's staring at you, and then we're up here talking about it. It makes it that bit more awkward.
How's the conversation in the car right now? What are you...
Yeah,
what kind of small talk do you make at this point?
Do you like this flavour of air freshener? I don't know. Let me lick it. You know, we got over 500 cars to get through this Burnout Championship elimination. We're on day two of pushing them through. They're still lined up. At 5 o'clock, though, we're going to the finals of the Burnout Masters. So if you want to be in the Burnout Championship elimination, you got to get out here. We got 2 hours left to make it happen, to pick our top 50 to go through the finals for tomorrow. If you are out in the crowd and you want to know, you want to see some Burnout action, this is the place to be. As I said, Burnout Championship elimination cars are lined up as far as the eye can see. And then, of course, we have got our Burnout Masters this afternoon from 5. 10 of the best in Australia, handpicked by our judges to go head-to-head. Matty Abu gives the signal for red flag to come on up. We've got two red flags out in the pad. Only two. In modern dating terms, that means promising relationship. Mad Nats on there. Jake Roberts is at the wheel. Fantastic little setup. He's got his passenger with the iPhone ready to film it. That makes you a professional photographer, Jake Roberts. Jake Roberts, Nissan Skyline. We expect to see those up at the Drift Academy up there at the shed. But no, Jake Roberts had it down here for the Burnout Championship eliminations. Red flag did him proud. What do you reckon, Sean? Would you buy a Nissan?
Absolutely. After that, great to see that Mad Nats mystique out there representing. He took it close to the wall on a couple of occasions, but fine driving skills on display amidst the smoke.
And that's what the judges are looking for. They're looking for the driver's skill. They're looking for the smoke, and they want to make sure that you can drive off that pad with only two front tyres inflated. We have got ourselves Gary Butler at the wheel. Gary Butler, too effing easy is the name of that ute, and he has done a fantastic job. He made it look far too easy, didn't he? The bumper's hanging off though, Sean. Do you reckon he'll pick up another one in the Rare Spares Pavilion?
No better place to be, no better time for it than Summonats 36 to pick up a spare or two from our great supporters at Rare Spares. And I reckon Gary Butler is, you know, limping his way over there, but with a big smile on his face.
Oh, he's a happy camper, happy camper. Crazy is coming up to the start line next. I'm still enjoying the replay up here on the big screen of Too Effin' Easy with Gary at the wheel. Commodores for days and days. Tyson Smith. VH Commodore, Crazy, ready to bring the action. Tyson Smith, Crazy, the VH Commodore. That was exceptional driving. I love watching him come back down the entry chute. Did a fantastic job. Passenger there, just getting out to make sure she's all tickety-boo. Can we drive off the pad? Sean, can you see if he's got any rubber left?
Can't see it, but I can see a passenger who's not just there for the ride, but there to help out as they skid on out. Exit shoot.
Oh, they're all there to help out. They're going to provide moral support, if nothing else. Big perp. Mad Nat sticker once more. Now, if anyone is out there on the live stream, thank you. But also, thank you to everybody in the grandstand who's live streaming the action from their point of view. I've been following you on Facebook and TikTok all weekend so I could stay up to date on what you're seeing. Andrew Moore right now in Big Perp. This is a cool old Kingswood.
Big Perp by name, will Big Smoke follow?
I reckon we got a pretty good chance of seeing some Big Smoke. Will we see Big Purple Smoke? I love a good collar tyre. Andrew Moore, just waiting for Manny Abood to give him the final instructions. Of course, our Hall of Famer who works here every year at Summonats. Green flags are out. Off we go. We got silence. I hate silence in a burnout pad. What is going on down there? Andrew Moore, Big Perp. I can't see a thing. Oh, noise. That's good. Keep the noise going. We got some red flags, but we got some noise. Oh, we're in the exit chute. If you're like me and losing your bearings. Fantastic job from our staff down there. Getting down to make sure that Big Perp is going to be healthy. We don't want anything upsetting the big girl. Bonnet's coming up, that's not a good sign. It's not a good sign, but on the upside, we can't see any marshmallow toasting kind of flamage. You think so, Maddie? From Tassie, you think? It's a long way to come to end up in the exit chute. What I fear is we also have at least one wheel still up on the back. We're not seeing any rubber popped, we're just seeing a bonnet popped. Poor old Andrew. Straight to skid row, punish Big Perp, teach it a lesson, make sure it pulls its head in and behaves next time.
If nothing else, the crowd's down on the fence right near the exit chute. Get a longer look at that beautiful paintwork on this HZ Kingswood. Oh, it's a beautiful car. It's sad to see it perpendicular in the exit chute that way. That's not the way it should be facing at a time like this.
It is, and I have a horrible feeling it's going to require some special assistance to get back out. Three-point turn of the worst variety. Look at the team. Everybody just gets in and pushes. You couldn't fit another pusher on that car right now. But on the upside, no Triton required. We're close enough to the exit.
Yeah, let's clap them off, folks. That's great teamwork, no matter which way you look at it.
Give our Tassie lad Andrew some love as he makes his way off. We have got a very special lady at the wheel for our next car that's coming up. Her name is Britt Kilby. I'm going to take a stab and say in the passenger seat is our Masters finalist, Brad Kilby, her hubby. Now, Britt was out here the other day, on Thursday, actually. She was out here for the wild card shootout. A little bit hawky about the moisture on the pad, but she is back right now for the championship. This car's got to turn around by 5 o'clock for Brad to come out as our fifth entrant in the Masters. We're hoping he'll be back tomorrow for the finals. Summonats 36, give it up for Hammer Time.
How's that for a happy husband and wife partnership?
Look, that is the babe of the burnout pad, Brittany. Hubby Brad, I was a little bit worried, you know, Sean, I was thinking, Brad's going to come out in just 2 hours in this car. Is Britt going to hold back? Is she going to, like, play it safe so that the Hammer Time is in one piece for 5 p.m. for the Masters finals? But I think she gave it everything she had. That is a happy hubby. That is a happy lady. Fantastic work, Britt Kilby. She is trying her best to get into the finals for the Burnout Championships here at Summonats 36.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Make some more noises. They head off. on two rims at the wheel, at the rear, I should say, folks. That is seriously good stuff ahead of our Burnout Masters.
I'm willing to say that's the meanest Daihatsu in Australia. That thing is mental. They have not only got to get off the pad under their own steam now to make it through, and that's it's a little bit slippery when all you got is metal, but they've got to get that car off the end of the pad. They've got to get it back to their camp, put new wheels on it, and get it lined up ready for the Masters finals, which are kicking off at 5 p.m. Daylight savings time. Of course, if you're on the live stream, that'll be a different time depending on where you are. I'm not going to guess. Hammer time. Come on, Britt.
Come on. Wheeling it across the line, because this Daihatsu is not done for the day. Fingers crossed we can get her out of here without too much more trouble.
I have complete faith. Those two have got the kind of relationship that'll just hold Hammer time until it gets across the line. Fantastic effort there, Britt. I am super proud of you. Daniel Vella down here in Fry LC. How pretty is this little Tirana with a West End Performance donk in it? Just making sure we have got the pad clear. Green flag is out. Rollo giving them the last little words of wisdom. Daniel Vella at the wheel. Burnout Championships.
Big action coming out the back there of that Tirana.
Oh, have a look up on the big screen. You can see a bit of flameage against the wall, but we want to make sure when you've got a car that beautiful that you'll look after it, and that's what our fireys are out there doing right now. I reckon Daniel is not going to limp off the pad. I reckon he's going to come back for more action. What do you think, Sean?
I love that energy. I myself, I'm a little bit more hedging my bets on this one. Our safety team out there checking out Daniel Vella's car closely before letting him go again.
What do you think, crowd? Should we give him a bit of love? See if he can start it up and finish those tyres? Yes, yeah, see? Someone at 36 agrees with me. We want to see more out of Daniel. Will the Fieries let him go? They want to see more too.
He's parked in an absolute midden of burnt rubber from the previous burnout.
That's just going to give him traction to build on.
Yes, I like that.
A little bit of Hammer Time rubber for him to move. Fry LC, Daniel Vella. Show us what we came here for, sir. Come on. Yeah, you'd be protecting that body, that paint. You don't want it anywhere near that signage. Oh, yeah. Told you, Sean. He's not going to leave quietly into the good night. Daniel Vella, Fry LC, give him some love, folks. You are looking at the Burnout Championship eliminations at Street Machine Summon at 36, proudly supported by Rare Spares. You're on the Rod Shop Burnout Pad. Sean and I are here. We're having a great time. Maddie Cav will be back shortly. 5 o'clock, Maddie and I are going to be talking up the top 10 Masters finals. Right now, Dean Air in rumbles. It looks so cute. It's a cute little car. KE55 Corolla. These are, like, I don't think you can buy these for your grandma anymore. They've all been taken up as burnout cars, the Corollas. Everybody's hunting them, and it's hard to find one that's not molested in some way. Right now, though, Dean Air is going to take rumbles out there and show us what it's made of. Dean, there's one left. Don't quit.
Still time.
No, red flags are out. No more time. We had Dean Air in Rumbles. That was awesome. I reckon it's the original suspension there in Grandma's shopping cart. That was fantastic from the little Corolla. He threw it about, had absolutely no fear. Look at it up on the replay here. Bonnet's a little bit cracked, but that's okay. We're not using it much. Look at him. It is violent the way he throws it around. I hope he's strapped in well. Yeah, maybe invest a little in suspension. Hypo XD coming up to the line right now. Bob Rushby at the wheel. He's got himself a passenger. I'm always amazed when I see cars come to the start line, Sean, and they don't have a passenger. I'm thinking, are you antisocial? Because you're going to have a friend. If you've got a car here, there is someone willing to get in as a passenger, so it must be you. Bob Rushby, Hypo XD, give him some love. The big four doing him proud. We're in the eliminations of the Burnout Championships here. We've got over 500 cars entered. Only 50 will go through to the finals tomorrow. 10%. I reckon out of the 500 nominated though, 10% might have had a little accident on Skid Row already and don't make it to the championship eliminations. There is a little bit of, what's the word? Attrition. Attrition, big word. Too big for me today. Big like wheelbarrow. All right, we have got our next Falcon coming to the start line. Isn't it nice to say two Falcons in a row instead of two Commodores? Quite a bit different. Replay up there on Hypo XD. Love that overhead cam. Fantastic action. Right now, though, Robert Noakes is down here.
Robert Noakes in the EL Falcon. Big scream on the tyres as we get started with that smoke. Let's see how we go. Rob Noakes there, he's relieved himself of a bonnet. Will he do so with some tyres?
did he go?
Oh, he's right out the exit chute. I think we lost one, but not the other there.
Robert Noakes, giving it everything the Big Falcon had. Oh, this is awesome. How many cars have we got to get through in the next how long? Someone tell me. 33 cars to get through in the next hour? Hour and a half. 33 Burnout Championship elimination cars left. Awesome is that. I'm loving looking at the faces down here. Plenty of fashions, plenty of mullets, plenty of tattoos, and plenty of rubber covering all of your faces. Beautiful to see. Now, this car is parked around near the Grey Camp at the moment. Your Jizz is the name of this big Commodore wagon. Jake Matheson at the wheel. Grim Industries up the side. Looks like a serious bit of gear, doesn't it, Sean? We expect big things.
Big call on the plates. Let's see if he can bring it to the pad.
Jake Matheson, Yule Jizz is the name of that wagon, and tell you what, I think he had a pretty good time out there. Give him some love, Summonats 36.
Ah, yes, that's not any Saturday morning trip to the shop station wagon. Jake Matheson putting on a show. Give him some love, folks.
Now, can he make it off the pad? I definitely saw two rear wheels get popped out there. He's going to have to spin them, taking rims to the rear end. We have got so much more Burnout Championship action for you. Pad staff are out there doing a cleanup right now. We're just going to take a little break. Deep breaths. Please grab yourself a refreshing beverage. We will be back in just a moment with more Burnout Championship eliminations.
I knew she was the one. My heart's going a million miles an hour. The mouth's dry. It's love, mate. Pure and simple. In 71, this was the fastest four-door car in the world. Back then, you could pick one up for a bit over $4,000. Insurance. It's got to be Shannon's.
No one knows your passion like Shannon's. That's why we offer choice of repairer, plus pay by the month premiums at no extra cost. So call Shannon's on 13 46 46. Shannon's, insurance for motoring enthusiasts.
We hope you're enjoying your summer out so far. Come see myself, Rory and the crew down at our Tough Streeters Marquee. We've got all the giveaway cars there and you can sign up for a membership as little as $5 a week. Scan all the QR codes you see. I'll see you on Skid Row.
Street machine or a race car, Aeroflow Performance has a solution for you. Our ever-increasing range features boosted turbocharger systems, Bosch Motorsport products, X-Pro electrical systems, hoses and fittings, bang shift shifters, differential parts, and fabrication components. You can see it all on aeroflowperformance.com.
Feral 8, another Falcon coming up. I feel like we saved all our Falcons for the end of the Burnout Championship elimination. Welcome back here, and welcome if you're on the live stream out there. We are having an absolute blast here at Street Machine Summonats 36, proudly supported by Rare Spares. Corey Connor at the wheel of Feral 8. I'm going to guess it's an 8-cylinder. What do you reckon, Sean?
I reckon that was a cheeky hint to us here in the comm box. Makes it easy. Let's make some smoke.
Corey Connor, Feral 8. It was pretty feral. I really liked that, actually. It was a good skid. Good, solid skid. What do you reckon, Sean?
Businesslike got in, the 1-2 pop, and then out the other end.
I think what we need to do, Sean, is get you in a passenger seat. Yeah. Maybe a Toyota. You like Toyotas?
I do. I like me a Japanese car. Although the fear is starting to rise.
Well, we did have a burnout car here a few years ago called Fear. Caught fire. It was terrible. Poor old Freddy. Anyway, oh, Freddy,
exactly.
Fear, fire. Mr. Mullet. Mr. Mullet is not afraid of being innovative with his metal fabrication skills. It's a tonner, though, and I do love me a tonner. Raceworks on the... Simon Biggs down in the driver's seat right now. Simon has a friend. It's good to see passengers. I hate to waste a passenger seat ride. Simon Biggs, Mr. Mullet, oh my golly gosh. Give him some love.
It looks like a chimney and it's smoked like one. There go the tyres. Here comes the photo opportunity, folks. Enjoy it, Mr. Biggs, Mr. Mullet.
He's had that car for about 10 years, been doing burnouts for about 5 years. He has been working on it non-stop. I think he loves it. I think we all love it. Outstanding effort there. I think we're down to about 30 cars to punch out in the next hour and 15. Then, of course, make sure you've got your beverages and snacks at hand. You've been to the bathroom because you don't want to miss the last hour here from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. when we have the 10 Burnout Masters finalists come on through.
That'll be the best burnout artists, I'm going to call them, not just in Australia, but the world, I reckon, at this point. Nobody
they
does it like
artists.
We do.
Yeah, they are artists, and they definitely paint this pad with rubber. Right now, I'm relieved to say we've got ourselves a Commodore. Haven't had one for a couple of cars. Fantastic to see. Hasta! Emrali, is on the pad. Vista Hosta is making his way off the far end. Emirali, is it? Give him some love. He's a very happy man. Oh, look at the high-fiving. It was kind of high-fiving. I love the bromance out there. There was a lot of bro love when these guys get out of the car.
A little bit of a tickle up the tailpipe as they head on down the exit chute. Emirali, is it done with Hosta or not quite yet? Looks like we might see a little bit more.
Marshmallow territory, that's what you need out there. Marshmallow, stat. Toast them up nicely. Got Nuts is coming up next. Or Go Nuts. Good, you know, I might have it the wrong way around. Adam Slorick. He is a regular on burnout pads all over Australia. The little methanol-fueled car down here. HB Tirana. A few of those getting around the drag racing scene now.
It's a showstopper of a car, hopefully
it was not a wall stopper then. I was a little bit worried, Adam. I'm glad you saw it and pulled up.
Thank you.
Adam Slorik, HB Tirana there, called Got Nuts. Now, I don't know how he's going to go with the judging. Remember, this is the Burnout Championship eliminations. Sean, they're looking for the smoke, but they're also looking for the driver skill. And if you grab reverse, you're not disqualified, but you're not loved.
Yeah, a little bit of a hiccup there, but a beautiful car looking down from the comm box, the interior. One to watch. Up next, who we got?
Light 'em up. Now, this is a serious bit of gear again. I would love this as a ringtone on my phone if anyone can record this motor for me. Oh, my goodness. It is Dominic Lucci at the wheel. Former Burnout Master, is that what you just told me, Maddie? Oh, well, he knows how it works then. He's been out in the pad. He has not actually won a Burnout Masters, but he has definitely been in the Burnout Masters previously. We're just going to have a moment here.
This is a brand new rebuild for Dom Lucci. He does all the drag racing, everything. He's got a few cars out there. We saw him with that beautiful car that was entering the Grand Champion last year as well. So. But he loves these things, and this car used to have naturally aspirated LS3. We saw it for a number of years competing around the country doing burnouts, but brand new engine combination. You can see the massive injector hat hanging out the front for Dom Lucci. Redone the entire car, brand new paint job on it, and unfortunately, as it is with new combinations, there's always a few teething issues.
Yeah, you got to tweak it a bit.
For me, I was looking around the corner and he came right here, very close to that corner where the tyre barrier is, and for a moment my heart stopped and it's... jumped into my mouth and I was like, don't. It's a gorgeous new car. I've been there having a bit of a look at it. I quite like Don Lucci's cars when he turns them out. They're always very beautiful. Make some noise to Don Lucci, ladies and gentlemen. Definitely knows how to steer a car. Doesn't matter whether it's just going fast in a straight line or we're working our way around a burnout pad. And no mechanical sympathy no matter what he does.
No. He builds them to break them, I think. He's having a great time out there. Please give him some love, because he's not going to need that other horrible beast to come out and help him. He is going to make it off the pad under his own steam. Do you reckon he's done, though? Is he going to go quietly into the good night?
Oh, there's a moment. I don't know. Look, I think he knows. When it comes to the judging, that is run and done for you.
Yes, no, judging, yes, but you can still have fun, can't you?
Is this double
We've got our wild card back. Ryan Burnell in Mad Dog. Of course, if you didn't get through the wild card shootout into the finals and then into the Masters, you are perfectly eligible to come in and have a go in the Burnout Championships.
Burnell up there in the exit chute. Looks like we've got a spot of bother.
Oh, he's coming back. I can see him emerge from the smoke. Give Ryan some love in Mad Dog.
Thank you.
Ryan Burnell and Mad Dog makes his way off the pad. Geez, we've got some nice cars lined up here for the remainder of the Burnout Championship eliminations. Bad HT is coming up to the start line right now. A few HTs coming through this week. Big Orange Ute looking awfully happy to be here at Summonats 36, proudly supported by Rare Spares. Alex Hurst is at the wheel. Let's see what he can do here for the Burnout Championship. Alex Hurst, he's somewhere down in that smoke. Can anyone see him? Make some noise if you can see Alex down there in one bad HT.
Well, it's about 3 years ago, it's your Alex Hurst taking on the wild card here for the Masters at the Summonats Burnout Pad. Unfortunately, that time, Rodney came a knocking. Much better result there for Alex Hurst. Hope he got those tyres off before he exited the Burnout Pad down the far end. Now back from a wild card entry, the tap on the roof. It's had a fair bit of journey this year. I think that might be, oh no, we got a passenger on board. He's from just outside the ACT, the big block BG engines combination together. Todd Stewart now about to grace his presence with a big thud in Unfazed. Listen to the crowd as he drives off the Burnout Pad. Todd Stewart in Unfazed.
I don't know if anyone else heard, but I kind of let out a little squeal and I stopped breathing for a minute because I was sure he was going to get that corner. Stone Hurt Unfazed. She is too beautiful.
It's had a fair bit of work this year too.
Oh, it's a beautiful car Todd Stewart has. Right now though, we've got Brendan Stone down here. He thinks he's a mini trucker. Mini trucker. Brendan Stone, VPR Auto, all up the door. Brendan's. Oh, he's got a horn. He's got a horn, folks.
How,
give
how
him
can
some
you
love.
Tell from here?
Well, because I heard it, oh. Matty. I heard okay. it. Brendan Stone, the little truck down there, he's had a blast. Give him some love. Oh, he's going to make it off the pad, isn't he? Is he getting out?
I hope so, but I'm looking at only one shredded tyre on the right-hand side, unless that's rubber hanging down, and one tyre with air. And we know what that means on any burnout pad that you grace in Australia, but especially when you're here for the main party at the Rod Shop burnout pad is... We don't like seeing that.
Do you think, from a judging point of view, you get more points if you're in a little truck like that and you have dualies on the back and pop all four?
Well, this has been done before.
Has it? Of course
yes.
it has. Is there
and,
anything...
And I've never had the question answered is the answer to that one. Oh!
There's
no,
the answer to a question
on.
We don't ever want to hear.
Is it doing a U-turn? Wait. Oh, is the rope about to come out? It's time for the Triton of Doom.
They don't bring it out to ask questions. They don't bring it out for moral support. They only bring it out as a last resort. So if it's here...
They did once, remember, earlier today. They brought it out and it didn't happen. Just the sight of the Triton scared.
good behaviour.
You can't frighten a Triton, but a Triton can frighten something else. That's what I'm saying. Can frighten any car back to life.
Oh, they're very frightening indeed.
Great to see so many people starting to make their way down to the grandstand, especially our platinum ticket holders, because the Burnout Masters is under 1 hour away from getting their competition set. 10 have made it through after what was an incredible elimination.
Do you know how I know that that's happening at 5 o'clock? Summonats app downloaded it, sent me a notification, tells me when the cool stuff is happening and I have to be there. But yeah, you've got under an hour. We've got the last of our Burnout Championship eliminations going through. Make sure that you have a great seat. Make sure that you have a refreshing beverage to stay hydrated and some snacky snacks.
Oh, we've got an hour of action-packed burnouts coming your way from 5 to 6 p.m. There is no other way to describe it than it'll be one of the most exhilarating moments of your life here at Summonats. We know there's everything going on, but for that hour, for us, there is only one thing happening, and that is right here at the Rod Shop Burnout Pad. Still a lineup of cars. We were down to about 28 still left to go in our normal Burnout Championship qualifying session. Of course, our top 50 will go through tomorrow to the Burnout Championship finals.
There's some big cars lined up.
And, of course, the rest of the Masters that didn't make it through the qualification.
Redemption
round. We'll be back. Well, let's get back on with this qualifying session for the Burnout Championships.
Bankrupt came out this morning. Very, very impressive skid. Has 3 entry numbers on the windscreen. So
we make it up as we go.
Yeah. Bryce Lucas could be behind the wheel.
Could
maybe.
Be.
Maybe not. Bankrupt.
Lucas giving the throttle salute, driving off the burnout pad. Bankrupt, 3 entries on that car. It has done some hard work this weekend already. We're in day number 3 of competition here at the Street Machine Summonats 36, proudly supported by Rare Spares. And It's not ending. I can see cars for days and days. They are still down there.
Tough 253s down there.
Tough 253.
Ooh, that's a nice little car. Nice.
Yes.
Nice. We've got some beautiful cars coming up still. All right, now we've got ourselves a Commodore Ute down on the pad. Guy Tuckett in Man's Dream. I love it when grandmas get involved. All right, this one's for Nana. Guy Tuckett, Nan's Dream, making his way up the end of the pad there. That was a solid effort. Nan would be proud. Oh,
when we talk about how much real estate they use in the burnout pad, he used a lot.
Yes.
And a lot, and a lot of real estate. Have a look at the replay here as the car takes off. Plenty of smoke, though. Really impressed with the amount of speed, especially when we don't have the massive horsepower engine in the front of it. And look at this. Two donuts done in the burnout pad as well. And we aren't seeing so many of the drivers doing that. They're getting one donut and going to that exit chute. So third donut there. And ooh, he was getting so close to some of those big concrete barriers we've got out there. And there was a light that was not looking too shabby after that burnout either.
There was a little bit of hanging bumper.
Yes. Anyway,
hanging bumper.
That's what happens. It's the carnage that is burnouts. We're right here at the Rod Shop burnout pad. The Street Machine Summonats and... our starter saying, bring the cars on. Let's not muck around. We're ready to go.
We are so ready to go. We got ourselves a Toyota. Sean has gone off to do bigger and better things without us, but he would love a Toyota. We got ourselves hijacked Toyota Hilux. Coming up to the start line right now with Jack Abrahat.
It's a one-tonner.
It's a one-tonner. I love a flatbed.
Jack Abrahat coming forward in this Toyota Hilux. Looks like it's got... I'm just going to double check this because there might be in there. It is a small block Chev in the front of it too. The hijack guys, make a bit of noise. I want you to gear them up. Let's do it here at Summonats.
Thank you.
Gabrielhart there. Hijacked. He is going off the pad. He went off on the pad. He had a fantastic time out there. I tell you what, the suspension on the back of that Hilux.
Yeah, a couple of moments around there. Let's check out the replay there. Started off really well. Look at the passenger jam, the crowd up as they go in. Big tip in there in the car. Oh, just then, right then, something happened and it'll come to a stop for just a moment there. They managed to get it started again, though, and that is the best thing. We don't give up on the burnout pad because tyres are not allowed to drive off with air in them. If we possibly can, if there's some way of starting it, we are going to smash those tyres. Look, move it over to the left here. The little Dado Ute is getting ready to come
Daniel
out.
Daniel Battersby is at the driver's seat.
Battersby, his dad's been here as a burnout master before. Let's see how he goes in the Dado.
Maddie, Daniel Battersby there. Impressive. Launched, turned in the chute. I was very impressed. I thought, here we go. This kid is going to paint every inch of this pad with that ute. Didn't. Left a little bit behind.
There's a little bit of real estate not used. That's all I... Look, positively, mate, he took off. Instant smoke. Lots of smoke coming out of the back of the little Dado. Did the donut nice and early in the chute as well. So he's trying to do something a little bit different with the judges. And we're only seeing maybe like 2% of the entrants try and do that sort of stuff.
And that once
got going, the
it.
RPM was constant throughout the entire burnout as well. He just kept the RPM nailed throughout the entire thing. Problem with the short wheelbase cars, if you don't have enough momentum, it just wants to keep spinning around on you. So it becomes very difficult then to get out of that.
A little bit of a pirouette princess sitting out in the middle there, but I think Daniel had fun. He looked like he was having a good time.
Does
out
anyone
there.
Not have fun at Summonats? I mean, you can have disappointment, you can have an emotional moment, but do you ever not have fun?
Yeah, no, I was chatting to some of the guys down there in the lineup before, and they're like, we're here to have fun. That's what everyone's here for. That's what Summonats 36 is all about. Have fun, smash tyres, enjoy cars, and have a great time.
Don't forget, our Burnout Masters kicks off at 5 p.m. this afternoon, sharp. 5 to 6 p.m. where 10 of our Burnout Masters made it through from their qualification, and they're going to fight it out to see who's going to be our Burnout Master here at Summonats 36 for 2024. Get themselves a big win, and we will be presenting that tonight over in the main arena from 8 p.m.
Now, if you're wondering how to prepare for the Burnout Masters finals, obviously get yourself some beverage, get yourself some snacks. But get your limmy finger ready and make sure that it's nice and flexed up, it's stretched, it's ready to go.
I'm going
to
say there's the 10 that got through, there's probably not going to be too much use of the limmy finger. I reckon the limmies are going to be gone. There's going to be no limiters. I reckon they are going to rev those things sky high.
You shouldn't save the limmy finger just for limiter. You should use it all the time as a sign of respect and support.
Yes.
These guys are going to need your respect and support
when
they come out here.
Cheering as well.
Oh, yeah. Bit of that.
Save a little bit of voice for the Masters. You've been using it all day. It's been a fantastic crowd here for some. That's we can't thank you enough for joining us for another year of this horsepower festival.
Oh, how mean does this big beast look? Jet 346, adrenaline enthusiast. I have no doubt that they are. Josh Hall at the wheel. Is that who we're talking to, Maddie?
Josh Hall it is in Jet 346. Just, oh, I love it when it just is that rump about it when you get a blown V8. Hear it. It's just...
telling you, it's a ringtone.
It's the calm. It's like, you know, watching a calm sea, you know, it's like glass.
It's very meditative.
All of a sudden, the storm rolls in and the noise comes and we get the clouds of smoke coming out of the back tyres. It's not too far away. Just waiting a moment for our starter to be given the signal. Will our staff look like they have left the pad? Oh, Matty Apodi wants to give the green light. He's keen. Yeah, sitting there, it'll be fueling up those carbies. Just give it a clear of the throat, waiting for the final instruction. We know when Rollo leaves the car that we're about to get underway. Car's still lined up here for our Burnout Championship qualifying session as well. You can see our masters starting to roll in. The nerves will be starting to set in a little bit. They'll be getting anxious. Get the cars around, get them fueled up, and then get them in the line, ready to go. Brian Smiley will be our first car out when it comes to the Burnout Masters. Drew the number one. Here we go, Rollo leaving the pad, which means we're about to get back underway with Josh Hall in Jet 346. Oh, that's not what he wanted. Starter up, starter up. He's just getting the crowd on the edge of their seat. That's all he's doing. He's trying to build the anticipation. You can do it.
Commentary curse, mate. You build it up too much.
I never said he was going to hurt it. I was just
Jet 346 went, nah, I'm not going to play the game now.
It's like, what are we doing? The crowd spooked it. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Got spooked on the start
line.
Okay.
Maybe the crowd needs to give her a little love.
Oh, is that what it needs? Some crowd interaction.
Oh, we can only hope. It just sat there too long. It was ready a minute ago. Tell you what, I'm ready. I'm ready for more Burnout Championship eliminations. I'm ready for the Masters final. I'm ready to be heading across for the Super Cruise later on tonight in the arena. Plenty of action. All right, folks, we have just heard it's actually not Jet 346 that is the problem. It's actually, well, it's not that it's a problem.
Well,
but
he doesn't have a problem. No. He's going to be back out there. But we are hearing that we are going to be shutting down the burnouts now until 5 p.m. this afternoon.
Yeah, so unfortunately fortunately means we've got a little break.
We do have a little break here on the Rod Shop Burnout Pad. We do have some things coming your way, though. We're waiting for some updates here on the Burnout Pad. We'll let you know we're about to start and we know more. We know we will be out on the pad probably about 10 to 5, quarter to 5. We have a very special moment there where we pay a bit of homage to someone who's very dear to the hearts here at Summernats, and their family and friends are here, and we want to have some kind words for them here at Summernats. And then we've got the Burnout Masters straight away after that at 5 p.m. where it's all going to go down. We've got to the 10 best burnouts here this weekend. Can they back it up? Can they do it again? There's a couple of Burnout Masters in that crew. Timmy Brown's back. He's gone from wild card. Then he's gone into the qualifications for the Burnout Masters. Now he's through to the finals. He did that a couple of years ago and took the win. Can he do that again? Will Rick Fuller get a second car as a Burnout Master? He's won it once, but it was a different car.
Could my dreams come true, and could Lynchy be the man who takes it this year? Because, gosh, I want him to.
I don't know. Could Chris Orchard take it back to Western Australia? They're naturally aspirated. We are trying to remember. It must be about some of that's 21, I want to put it out, with the last naturally aspirated car won.
Yes, well, that's what I have heard. But then also, could it be Hammer Time? Could it be that a car that's entered in the championships and the Masters comes through with two drivers for two different titles? That would be exciting.
We haven't had that yet.
No.
We've had one driver with two cars where they've won the championship and the Masters, but we've never had
husband-wife
one car win the Masters and the championships.
Yeah. So, folks, you've got about 20, 25 minutes to go for a stroll, stretch your legs, make sure you've got some beverages, got some snacks. We're going to make sure this pad is schmick-as ready for the Masters this afternoon. Apologies to everybody that we can't run through the last of the championship eliminations, but they'll be on first thing.
We're going to be back in 5 minutes, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, 5 o'clock.
Five o'clock.
Don't get me excited there. I know about 4:15, 10:05, we will have a special presentation out on the Burnout Pad, so make sure you're back for that, ladies and gentlemen. Take a break from our beautiful voices, and we will let you talk to some of our sponsors out there who support us here at Summernats and make this fantastic event so you can all enjoy it. Woo!
accessible for everyone. Our most durable formula ever, with 1 year paint protection. Meguiar's new hybrid paint coating. Meguiar's, reflect your passion.
I knew she was the one. My heart's going a million miles an hour, the mouth's dry. It's love, mate. Pure and simple. In 71, this was the fastest four-door car in the world. Back then, you could pick one up for a bit over $4,000. Insurance. It's got to be Shannon's.
No one knows your passion like Shannon's. That's why we offer choice of repairer, plus pay-by-the-month premiums at no extra cost. So call Shannon's on 13 46 46. Shannon's, insurance for motoring enthusiasts.
Whether you're building a street machine or a race car, Aeroflow Performance has a solution for you. Our ever-increasing range features boosted turbocharger systems, Bosch Motorsport products, X-Pro electrical systems, hoses and fittings, bang shift shifters, differential parts, and fabrication components. You can see it all on aeroflowperformance.com.
Rare Spares has over 50,000 product lines and releases over 500 new products every year. Your local Rare Spares distributor has what you need when you need it. And as the only restoration company officially backed by Holden and Ford, we take our part in your project very seriously. Rare Spares, more than just a part in your project.
Enjoying your summer night so far, come see myself, Rory and the crew down at our Tough Streeters Marquee. We've got all the giveaway cars there and you can sign up for a membership as little as $5 a week. Scan all the QR codes you see. I'll see you on Skid Row.
HQ.
Has over 50,000 product lines and releases over 500 new products every year. Your local Rare Spares distributor has what you need when you need it. And as the only restoration company officially backed by Holden and Ford, we take our part in your project very seriously. Rare Spares, more than just a part in your project.
Giving you the chance to win one of five Milwaukee automotive toolkits. The 36-inch toolkit has 238 pieces and is worth $2,800. To enter, sign up to receive Shannon's e-newsletters at shannons.com.au/Milwaukee.
Spares has over 50,000 product lines and releases over 500 new products every year. The local Rare Spares distributor has what you need when you need it. And as the only restoration company officially backed by Holden and Ford, we take our part in your project very seriously. Rare Spares. More than just a part in your project.
Boom, baby, we're right here, Wheel Pros Australia HQ.
Who are innovating and smashing stereotypes. And the doers who help keep this country running. The doers owning the weekend. And the doers who never take the morning off. We've been powering the doers for over 25 years. Gear Wrench. Forge ahead. Find your local pro stockist at gearwrench.com.au.
Whether you're building a street machine or a race car, Aeroflow Performance has a solution for you. Our ever-increasing range features boosted turbocharger systems, Bosch Motorsport products, X-Pro electrical systems, hoses and fittings, Bangshift shifters, differential parts, and fabrication components. You can see it all on aeroflowperformance.com.
Spares has over 50,000 product lines and releases over 500 new products every year. Your local Rare Spares distributor has what you need when you need it. And as the only restoration company officially backed by Holden and Ford, we take our part in your project very seriously. Rare Spares. More than just a part in your project. Stockist at gearwrench.com.au.
Whether you're building a street machine or a race car, Aeroflow Performance has a solution for you. Our ever-increasing range features boosted turbocharger systems, Bosch Motorsport products, X-Pro electrical systems, hoses and fittings, Bangshift shifters, differential parts, and fabrication components. You can see it all on aeroflowperformance.com.
Here, Wheel Pros Australia HQ.
hope you're enjoying your summer night so far. Come see myself, Rory and the crew down at our Tufts Traders Marquee. We've got all the giveaway cars there and you can sign up for a membership as little as $5 a week. Scan all the QR codes you see. I'll see you on Skid Row. Hope you're enjoying your summer night so far. Come see myself, Rory and the crew down at our Tufts Traders Marquee. We've got all the giveaway cars there. You can sign up for a membership as little as $5 a week. Scan all the QR codes you see. I'll see you on Skid Row.
Machine or a race car, Aeroflow Performance has a solution for you. Our ever-increasing range features boosted turbocharger systems, Bosch Motorsport products, X-Pro electrical system.
Enjoying your summer night so far, come see myself, Rory and the crew down at our Tufts Traders Marquee. We've got all the giveaway cars there and you can sign up for a membership as little as $5 a week. Scan all the QR codes you see. I'll see you on Skid Row.
My passion for cars began when Nana and Pop bought their new Toyota Crown. It was Nana's, really. She loved that car. We went everywhere in it. My passion now is just the same, even though my cars are a little different. I've still got Nana's car, couldn't part with it. And I reckon if she was here today, she'd be insured with Shannon's too.
Call Shannon's on 13 46 46. Shannon's, insurance for motoring enthusiasts.
Made Ride Shop is back at Summer Nats. Located on Tuff Street, check out the massive range of merchandise from t-shirts, hats, hoodies and beanies.
A Warbird. Mad.
See the updated Ferrari-powered rear-wheel Torana and the iconic Warbird XP Falcon on display. Pay us a visit on Tuff Street, shop online at rodshop.com.au.
For cars began when Nana and Pop bought their new Toyota Crown. It was Nana's, really. She loved that car. We went everywhere in it. My passion now is just the same, even though my car's a little different. I've still got Nana's car, couldn't part with it. And I reckon if she was here today, she'd be insured with Shannon's too.
Call Shannon's on 13 46 46. Shannon's, insurance for motoring enthusiasts. Motoring enthusiasts.
Rare Spares has over 50,000 product lines and releases over 500 new products every year. Your local Rare Spares distributor has what you need when you need it. And as the only restoration company officially backed by Holden and Ford, we take our part in your project very seriously. Rare Spares, more than just a part in your project. To the doers who are innovating and smashing stereotypes. And the doers who help keep this country running. The doers owning the weekend. And the doers who never take the morning off. We've been powering the doers for over 25 years. Gear Wrench. Forge ahead. Find your local pro stockist at gearwrench.com.au.
We hope you're enjoying your summer night so far. Come see myself, Rory and the crew down at our Tough Streeters Marquee. We've got all the giveaway cars there and you can sign up for a membership as little as $5 a week. Scan all the QR codes you see. I'll see you on Skid Row.
Spend a lot of time out here. The RT Charger's the real deal. An E49. Remember A Charger? I've always got projects on the go, so Shannon's laid-up cover helps protect my restorations. I'm Mopar through and through. It's a passion Shannon's understands. I wouldn't insure my cars and bikes with anyone else.
Shannon's, insurance for motoring enthusiasts. Call 1346 46 for a quote.
Rhys Bears has over 50,000 product lines and releases over 500 new products every year. Your local Rhys Bears distributor has what you need when you need it. And as the only restoration company officially backed by Holden and Ford, we take our part in your project very seriously. Rhys Bears, more than just a part in your project.
Spend a lot of time out here. The RT Charger's the real deal. An E49. Remember A Charger? I've always got projects on the go, so Shannon's laid-up cover helps protect my restorations. I'm Mopar through and through. It's a passion Shannon's understands. I wouldn't insure my cars and bikes with anyone else.
Shannon's, insurance for motoring enthusiasts. Call 1346 46 for a quote.
Whether you're building a street machine or a race car, Aeroflow Performance has a solution for you. Our ever-increasing range features boosted turbocharger systems, Bosch Motorsport products, X-Pro electrical systems, hoses and fittings, bang shift shifters, differential parts, and fabrication components. You can see it all on aeroflowperformance.com.
Castlemaine Ride Shop is back at Summer Nats. Located on Tuff Street, check out the massive range of merchandise from t-shirts, hats, hoodies and beanies.
Warbird. Mad.
See the updated Ferrari-powered Real Deal Torana and the iconic Warbird XP Falcon on display. Pay us a visit on Tuff Street or shop online at rodshop.com.au.
Bears has over 50,000 product lines and releases over 500 new products every year. Your local Rhys Bears distributor has what you need when you need it. And as the only restoration company officially backed by Holden and Ford, we take our part in your project very seriously. Rhys Bears, more than just a part in your project.
In Everybody looking at me while I got them all in my sights. Picking them off, taking them out, looking like daylight in the night. And I'm killing so many if they really want to get involved. And everybody falling in the elevator. Now I'm Ray Rice in this. It's like a rice and take a bite. It's nice and I have a nice time with it. By the time that it finds a way to the right side of him, not even a high nigga save on my selective finger to you imbeciles. Tell me what's been getting into you. I don't give a damn like I hide it with no time to kill. I'm a feeling like the opposite of work. It's a work and I've never been a purpose thing to me. I just do what I love and it works for me.
Whether you're building a street machine or a race car, Aeroflow Performance has a solution for you. Our ever-increasing range features boosted turbocharger systems, Bosch Motorsport products, X-Pro electrical systems, hoses and fittings, bang shift shifters, differential parts, and fabrication components. You can see it all on aeroflowperformance.com.
We hope you're enjoying your summer night so far. Come see myself, Rory and the crew down at our Tough Traders Marquee. We've got all the giveaway cars there and you can sign up for a membership as little as $5 a week. Scan all the QR codes you see. I'll see you on Skid Row.
Building a street machine or a race car, Aeroflow Performance has a solution for you. Our ever-increasing range features boosted turbocharger systems, Bosch Motorsport products, X-Pro electrical systems, hoses and fittings, bang shift shifters, differential parts, and fabrication components. You can see it all on aeroflowperformance.com.
Bears has over 50,000 product lines and releases over 500 new products every year. Your local Rare Spares distributor has what you need when you need it. And as the only restoration company officially backed by Holden and Ford, we take our part in your project very seriously. Rare Spares, more than just a part in your project.
Castlemaine Ride Shop is back at Summer Nats. Located on Tuff Street, check out the massive range of merchandise from t-shirts, hats, hoodies and beanies.
Warbird. Mad.
See the updated Ferrari-powered Real Deal Torana and the iconic Warbird XP Falcon on display. Pay us a visit on Tuff Street or shop online at rodshop.com.au.
Hope you're enjoying your summer night so far. Come see myself, Rory and the crew down at our Tough Traders Marquee. We've got all the giveaway cars there and you can sign up for a membership as little as $5 a week. Scan all the QR codes you see. I'll see you on Skid Row. We'll be right back.
she was the one. My heart's going a million miles an hour, the mouth's dry. It's love, mate. Pure and simple. In 71, this was the fastest four-door car in the world. Back then, you could pick one up for a bit over $4,000. Insurance. It's got to be Shannon's.
No one knows your passion like Shannon's. That's why we offer choice of repairer plus pay-by-the-month premiums at no extra cost. So call Shannon's on 13 46 46. Shannon's, insurance for motoring enthusiasts.
Simple. In 71, this was the fastest four-door car in the world. Back then, you could pick one up for a bit over $4,000. Insurance. It's got to be Shannon's.
No one knows your passion like Shannon's. That's why we offer choice of repairer plus pay-by-the-month premiums at no extra cost. So call Shannon's on 13 46 46. Shannon's, insurance for motoring enthusiasts.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome down to the Rod Shop Burnout Pad for Summonats 36, brought to you by Street Machine. This year we do have to, I suppose we need to do a bit of a homage to someone who was very dear to the hearts of us here at Summonats. And not only did this person be part of our crew, they were across the seas. They were a person who joined our judging team. They came over here with their burnouts. They started burnouts over in New Zealand. We're part of building that over there as well. And that is Jen Ireland, who we unfortunately lost in early December this year through to illness. So ladies and gentlemen, we just want to do a bit of a tribute to Jen, and I want to hear a few words from my husband, Rick, who's travelled all over Australia with his family here today.
Thank you, everyone. Sorry for the hold-up here. But, yeah, Jen was extremely passionate about burnouts. We had a really good run and just organically ended up being a judge here. She loved it. She, thrived on it. And us as a family and our friends here have had a great journey. Up until now, so yeah, really appreciate how we've been treated over here in Australia. We've made some great friends, lifelong friends, and it's been a thing.
Well done, Rick. Big round of applause for Rick there to say those words. I know it's very hard at this moment, ladies and gentlemen, but out of respect for Jen, please, we do have Lynch who's going to do a burnout for Jen in just a moment, but can we please have 1 minute silence? Please stand up and remove your hats for 1 minute silence. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your silence, please. For Jen Ireland, please thank Rick, their daughter Hannah and Max for being here in Australia, her extended family as well here on the burnout pad. Andrew Lynch, ladies and gentlemen, he went over to New Zealand. He was part of their competition over there. It was dear to his heart. He had to do this burnout for Jen please. We're going to move off the burnout pad, ladies and gentlemen. Make a lot of noise for Andrew Lynch. Ladies and gentlemen, cheer on Andrew Lynch in memory of Jen Ireland from New Zealand. Close to our hearts here at Summonats. Part of the family, part of the staff as well, and did a lot when it came to burnout judging. She flew over here to Australia and joined our judging team. Not only did she come over with burnout cars earlier than that, she came over and joined our burnout judging team and also did it remotely from over there. And so much consultation with them over in New Zealand with their burnouts happening as well. And Andrew Lynch, obviously very close to his heart. He had to come out and do a tribute burnout for Jen Ireland, and great to have her family here this weekend, as well as many New Zealanders who have travelled across. I'm sure it's very close to their hearts. We're glad you could cheer that on here in Australia. Be part of the burnout family here at Summonats. Our burnout master's not too far away now, ladies and gentlemen. 10 of them lined up. It's going to start off with Brian Smiley and tipping in before we go to Robert Cottrell in four to Haters. Then it's Rick Fuller in full on X. Adrian Cuthbertson will come out in Skidmore as the fourth car. Then Brad Kilby in Hammer Time. Timmy Brown and CM Blow. Justin Persikas in Refine. Then Craig Bailey in Imposter. Chris Orchard in The Game. And Andrew Lynch, that was not his master's burnout. That was purely a tribute to someone we lost early December in 2023, just 1 month ago. He is going to come back out, and that will be his judge skid. He'll be the final car to come out this afternoon for the Burnout Masters finals here. And we'll find out at 8 p.m. tonight who the winner will be over there in the main arena.
That was such a beautiful skid, wasn't it? It was such a touching tribute to Jen. We miss her greatly. Of course, we have got 10 of the most amazing burnout cars in Australia. We've still got plenty of burnout championship eliminations chomping at the bit to come out and show you what they can do as well. Right now, though, we're just going to wait for those cars to sort them out. We're going to make sure the pad to be absolutely schmicko. Look at the crowd out here, Maddie. Have you ever seen a better Summonats crowd?
No, I have never seen. Whether I've been in the crowd or whether I've been working here at Summonats, that is about 50 deep here on the main grass hill. We have filled the grandstand. Chick Henry will be proud. The Chick Henry grandstand absolutely full of all those people who grabbed their platinum passes. The Rodshot burnout pad is getting prepared for an onslaught of absolute weapons to hit this burnout pad. These drivers are, we can't call them professionals anymore. I suppose they're not. It's not a professional sport, but they're not amateurs.
No, definitely. They're paying lots of money. It's not they're being paid lots of money. They pay a lot of money to come and put on this show for you.
They're experienced sportsmen in this field of burnouts.
They are entertainers of the best variety. I think our crowd today is not just a huge crowd. It's also a crowd filled with beautiful people. Some of the mullets, some of the tattoos, some of the matching outfits. They're not just pretty, they smell lovely, and they are so passionate about burnout. Some of these guys were out here at 9 o'clock this morning waiting to see this show we're about to put on.
I'll tell you what, when it comes to Summonats, there is so much going on. There's normally about 20 to 30 things all happening at once. But when it comes to the late afternoon and the burnout master, it feels like it all comes around the burnout pad. All the attention comes down here to the Rod Shop pad for these 10 cars. Who will be lifted at 8 p.m. tonight? Because we know they always lift up the champion of the Burnout Masters. Brian Smiley now coming forward and tipping in. Well, he's been doing burnouts for many years. Small block Chev in between the chassis rails. This blown injected. We've got three natural aspirated cars. Well, he's not going down that path. He's going blown. And he is getting ready to get underway. B&R Engines, of course, got the sticker on there. We'll be making sure this car's running nice and sweet. the moment. The butterflies must be in the stomach. You're the first car out. He managed to get through Walger Zakowski, who actually got through into the 10. Had some engine issues there, said, I'm not going to skid. This was the next man on the score sheet after qualifying. Managed to slip his way in. What an opportunity for him.
He didn't even know he was going to be in the Masters Finals until today, but he is here, because who wouldn't be?
All right, it's time to kick off the Burnout Masters Finals, ladies and gentlemen. Make a whole heap of noise. Ryan Smiley and Tiffany.
Summer Nats 36 Burnout Master. Could it be?
You never know. You never know, do you?
Well, this is the thing. You've got to have the best burnout out there. But also, no one else can blow up. Like, no one else can have do anything wrong. So that was a nice, clean run.
Rob Cottrell in Ford Haters will be the next car to come to the start line. Well, he's from the Riverina area, sponsored by ABC Tyres. The Dua engine in between the shacks rails. Had a little bit of a refresh after an incident up there in Darwin, but this guy, he thrashes absolutely everything. Here he goes, Ford Haters. For Rob Cottrell on the back of Ford Haters. Cheer him on!
How good is that overhead cam up on the big screen? Live stream people, you must be loving it too. Robert did a fantastic job there. Love seeing the big Ford out in the pad.
Oh yeah, it's a big orange XD, but he manages to steer it around this time. He's been here in the Masters Dance a few times, but never stood on the top step of the podium. Could this year be his year? We will wait and find out at 8 p.m. tonight when we do the presentations. But driving off the burn, he needs to make sure he gets past the exit chute. Now, there is a line there on the exit chute, which is a boundary line. He has to get over that.
With his own steam.
Remembering the judges are looking for instant smoke, constant smoke, the volume of smoke throughout the entire burnout. Also driver control, they want to use as much of the burnout pad as possible. You can't come back across the start line. You can't get your car over that line where they exit the chute. There's a white line. You can't have any part of your car over that. So we'll have to wait and see. All right, up next, former burnout master himself a few years ago. Not only did he win the burnout master, he won the burnout championship in another car he had here on site. It is Rick Fuller out of Victoria in Full On X in this blown LS HX Kingswood. Where is Rick Fuller? He's somewhere in the smoke.
You can see why he's a previous Masters winner. Rick Fuller, Full On X. If anyone sees him, make some noise.
Getting ready. Other tyres, no. Something's happened. He's not going up. Cheer him on here at Summonats. Make a bit of noise. Who wants to see him finish the tyres off?
Smoke, he got a little lost down the other end. I feel like the second half of that skid was a punishment. Rick Fuller, tell him what you think, crowd.
Once he knew he'd had the cardinal sin, he had to reverse up. You knew it was all about showmanship. Putting on a show for the crowd here and getting the tyres off the back of Full On X in front of a packed crowd here at Street Machine Summonats 36. Wow, we are sold out, and I think everybody that bought a ticket is right here at the Rod Shop Burnout Pad at Summonats.
That's our third car, seven more to go, and you can see the caliber that we are working with. Of course, our pad staff running out there to make sure that every single one of these competitors is on an equal footing. Now, Adrian Cuthbertson and Skidmer should be up next according to the draw, but I've got Hammer Time sitting down here.
Maybe an issue there as they got the boot open. They might be some battery issues. We'll wait and find out. I'm sure they will make sure that gets out, but yeah, you can see Hammer Time coming forward. Now, let's have a talk about some of the things when it comes to the Masters judging, though, because people think it's all about what they do right. Well, when we get to the Masters, as you can see, they're at a certain caliber. They're all so similar that we actually start looking for the small things.
Yes.
It's you start starting with a perfect scorecard, and you start making deductions. I didn't quite use all the pad. You know, not mistakes, but like little things that they didn't quite carry out throughout the burnout. So when we have a look at the judging at the end of this, it's going to be, you know, within half a point on some of these places. So here we go. It's time. The finger is out. This car's already been out once today with his wife, Brett Kilby, in the Burnout Championships. Now it's back. Clear of the throat for the North Vic engines. 408 cubes of LS power. It's Brad Kilby. He's back in the Masters in Hammer Time. as he drives around the burnout pad down to just rims on the back of Hammer Time.
Brad and Britt do like to get out and say hello to the crowd. They're going to be pretty happy with that. Could this be the first car to win a championship and a Masters with two different drivers? Brad Kilby, Hammer Time. That was a pretty solid effort.
Just one of three natural aspirator cars, proving you don't have to be blown to be known when it comes to burnouts. And putting on an absolute epic display here in the Burnout Masters finals. He's been here before too, and he's I think he ended up in fifth or sixth actually out of that one. So
I just want to say this
really
also
show on.
Could be the first, and I haven't checked the facts, but could this be the first Daihatsu to take out Burnout Masters?
No, probably would be the first Daihatsu, I reckon.
Yeah, I don't even really feel the need to check that. We have got some amazing action for you. Unfortunately, Adrian Cuthbertson in Skidmore, we haven't seen him yet. Hopefully he'll come up.
There is a crew of people around there, so I'm sure they are trying to get that car sorted, because it would be a shame not to have Adrian Cuthbertson come out and get his opportunity in the burnout. It's the man who won it just 2 years ago, had to wait till Friday morning. And they said, you know what, you can come out this afternoon in the qualifications and have another go. And they said, well, you're in the 10 again, Tim. You've done it before. You got your mojo back. It's time for Timmy Brown in CMO. Down to just two rims on the back. Timmy Brown putting on an epic display once again. Can we hear you, Canberra?
Oh, he's not standing on the car. He's standing on the concrete barriers. Tim Brown's going to be pretty happy with that skid. It was solid.
He's a man of the people, isn't he?
He is, and I'm hoping he's a man of the podium later on tonight. Tim Brown, see him blow. Fantastic effort there, and I think that's probably one of the quickest we've seen out there too.
Well, I don't know. He actually used a lot of the pad. I think that's well and truly outside the 1 minute minimum for me.
Oh, yeah.
Because just seeing he came back down the entry chute, back down the exit chute, the amount of work he did throughout the burnout pad, great for the judges to see that, I think, when it comes to the driver's skill ability as well. So
you can
smoke
see
scores
why
for
won.
Me were right up there. They were incredible. But it's not all about the people on the East Coast. They are West Aussie visitors as well. They've come in numbers this year, and a couple of them have made it through to the Burnout Masters Finals. And the first man to come out from Western Australia will be Justin Persikas in this absolutely gorgeous car. Runs and owns BYE Performance, builds the engine, this absolutely gorgeous BMW M3. It is Ruffine. Come on, get him up for Justin Persikas in Ruffine.
What an outstanding effort there. Maybe it's the first year we have a BMW up as our burnout master. We have got such high caliber of cars here. Three more yet to run. Oh no, four, because we have Adrian Cuthbertson back.
He's fired up. He is fired up.
Just an outstanding effort there by Refined.
Do you know what BMW stands for, eh?
Yes.
Break my wallet.
Oh,
I think that probably did break the wallet on that bit. It's an absolutely gorgeous car. Wow, how are we loving the Burnout Masters so far, Summonats? Yeah, the best of the best here this year. And looks like we have got Skidmer fired up here in the staging lanes, not too far away after we just make sure our pad is fine. Now, this thing, well, wherever you are, it stops you in your tracks because of the noise it makes. He has won just about every burnout competition around Australia, but he's looking for this one. It's called a Masters win at Summonats. Just outside, up in central New South Wales there, the BG Engine small block in the front. It's Adrian Cuthbertson, it's Skidmer.
The Mitsubishi Sigma, Adrian Cuthbertson at the wheel of Skidmer. He is going to be taking that back. I reckon there's going to be some punishment on Skidmer.
He's a contender still. The hairy moment where my heart jumped into my mouth there, where he came back in the tip in from the exit chute there, and the front wheel's locked up, and he had to give it a couple of big pedals there to try and get the car turned around. Oh, just a moment there for me, it was.
Talking about big cars, imposter.
Well, VF Commodore Ute now. Warspeed LS with the blower on top, of course. It is Craig Bailey now coming out of the burnout pad in Imposter.
That's close. That's close. Anyone looking at the big screen?
Too close for comfort.
Thank you. said it before, Maddie, it's not just what you do right at this level of competition, it's what you also do wrong.
It's those little things that can take away from a perfect burnout in the Masters. Craig Bailey in Imposter did a fantastic job with that little moment there we saw up on our screens. Could that hurt him?
I stopped breathing.
Could that hurt him in the championship? Could that be the points that don't get him on the top three?
The thing is, in a standard competition, he might get away with it. But we're talking about 10 of the best drivers in Australia, and they're all going head-to-head. The slightest error will just drop you a couple of points and you are
and
out.
And that's the difference. A couple of points could be between, like a third place and about an eighth place here when it comes to the Masters.
Yeah.
It is so close at the top of the ranks when it comes to these burnout drivers. That's why these 10 made it through into the burnout finals here for the Masters. And don't forget to download the Burnout Masters app. If you want to play the game on your phone, you can do that straight after we finish all the burnouts. Of course, we don't want you to take away from what's happening here on the Rodshot Burnout Pad.
Well, we've got two more Masters up. We've got Chris Orchard in the game. We've got Lynchy. But then, are we going to get some more championship eliminations out? Because we've got a little bit of time up this week.
I'm just a mushroom.
Yes, I'm hoping. Like, I personally want to see more burnouts today.
We will find out. We've got till 6 p.m. tonight to get as much done as possible. Up next, another Western Australia. He's already been to the Burnout Master before. Unfortunately, didn't get on a podium, but it doesn't matter what he drives and where he drives it. He's got three cars at the moment. They all could have been here this weekend. He bought two of them. Unfortunately, game over didn't make it, but the game did. Nash Lasper right at horsepower, 10,000 RPM, Chris Orchard.
That is immaculate. Chris Orchard, the game. What do you think, crowd? Could that be our burnout master?
Surely that's not all we've got for Chris Orchard in the game. Come on, make some noise. Wow, you just heard through moments there. Oh, I think that's the limiter off that car. I think they absolutely threw it away in the bin. The engine builder sitting in the corner crying, go, please don't, Chris. Wow, the Western Australians do not muck around, and we've seen plenty of Western Australian burnout masters as well. What we haven't seen in many, many years, which we believe since someone that's 31, is a naturally aspirated burnout master.
21 or 31?
21.
Oh, 21.
Yeah, 21.
It's been a minute, but we have got one more contender here for burnout master.
Oh, we couldn't let this man go without a chant, ladies and gentlemen. Can we hear it in the crowd? You all know who he is. Lynchy!
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 Lynchy! Oh, this is it. I can't wait. Andrew Lynch!
keep cheering him on as he drives off the Rod Shop Burnout Pad, Mr. Andrew Lynch. Wow. Absolutely wow. When you see Andrew Lynch come down and do that in front of you, is it real?
The Chick Henry grandstand is almost pulsing with excitement over there. The crowd obviously loves him, but will the judges love him? You've just seen 10 of the best in Australia. Who is going to be our burnout master?
I'll tell you what, that one's going to be a tough one for the judges. That's our 10 wild cards, run and done for their finals. Brian Smiley, Rob Cottrell, Rick Fuller, Adrian Cuthbertson, Brad Kilby, Timmy Brown, Justin Pisikas, Craig Bailey, Chris Orchard and Andrew Lynch. We'll find out who's your burnout master here for Summit at 36 at 8 p.m. tonight on the main arena over there in the... Well, it's where the entertainment is.
Yeah,
it's where we're
going to
have
hot-tub
time machine, everything like that. So, you know, we've got the Super Cruise happening. In the meantime, we are going to go through as many burnout cars as we've got left. You don't have to
leave.
The burnouts
stay in the grandstands.
They don't stop till 6 p.m. tonight if you want to hang around here in the grandstands.
We have got plenty more cars, some big cars coming too, the likes of Tough 253 and so on. If you want to see more burnout action, don't leave now. You have just settled in. The shade's coming over. We have got Jet 346. It was on the start line before when we were told we had to be quiet for a little bit. They are going to come back out. We've got plenty of Burnout Championship car action for you here in the eliminations. Of course, we're going to push this through to 6 o'clock before we're told we have to go be good kids. Over at the Super Cruise, 8 o'clock, the big presentations tonight, and then live music. If you want to get out and have some dinner that's not on site here, you can head down to the Braddon Fringe Festival. But right now... Josh Hall, is that who we're talking about? Yes, it is. Josh Hall is down here on the start line. Good to see these Burnout Championship eliminations carrying on.
Well, the noise goes down and the tyres are finished on the back
for Josh Hall. Josh Hall, give him some love, Summonats. That was outstanding. Burnout Championship eliminations be continuing through to 6 p.m. Then we're across to the Super Cruise and then, of course, the Masters presentations to find out who the winner of those 10 will be. Thank you, Josh. Outstanding effort there. We've got Wild One down on the start line right now. I'm a little confused by the tray on this ute. I want to say Commodore, but it kind of looks Ford because it's so short and it's weirding me out.
Oh, the tray?
Yeah.
It is short.
Cameron Doyle at the wheel of Wild One. I like the name Wild. It's good.
Yeah.
You share it. Oh, the noise has gone out for Cameron Doyle.
The noise has gone... Oh, no, is it Cameron? I thought that was the number on it, but that's not a... wrong car.
Well, that was not nice.
Oh, no.
Oh, we're up against the wall. He's just sign shopping. He's trying to jam one in the back of that short tub.
I figured out what it is. Whoa! There goes the short tub.
More sign shopping.
It's a whole one tunnel with a cream and tub on the back.
Do you like one-tonners? Did I mention this?
But without a tonner tray.
One-tonner with a wild one number plate, I'll take it. Not a racetrack, burnout pad. Oh, sign shopping. All right, Cameron, please get off the pad. We've got more burnout championship elimination cars to come through. You got the red flags out. That's a sign. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here.
There are only so many deductions we can take out.
Look, there's only so many signs you can try and take with you.
Yes.
I think I counted three at least.
It's part of our contract. We have to have so many rod shops on the burnout pad, so many signs.
Yes.
And you've now taken most of them.
Oh, go away. He thinks red flags are just a sign you need to try harder in the relationship.
Yes, yes.
That's what he's thinking. Yeah.
Okay. That's what
you know, Maddie, I've been around burnouts for a minute now, and one of the first cars I saw out there was this next car coming up to the start line, and I fell a little in love with it. Tough 253. It always looks like a show car. Pristine. Shannon Herod at the wheel. I'm a bitter fan.
Who sticks with a 253 and tries to rev it past 8,000 RPM? Someone who's got some patience, and that is this man right here out of Victoria, Tough 253.
Who tries to put a 253 in an Escort?
They're small, they fit. It's not an LS, I'm just saying. I think it's like a 471 or a 371 on top of this from memory, mechanically injected. You don't see it every day, but the combination's been around for a few years now. It's lime green. I love it. It stands right out. Why are all our little cars lime green?
Safety colours. Safety colours. Don't want to get run over by a big car. Shannon Herod, Tough 253. I love this car. The little Ford Escort is going to show us how it's done as soon as we get the green flag from our pad staff. Matty Abu just having a quick word to him there. Look, even the fire suits have got green. Green is go. We want green flags.
Tap on the roof. Track. Here he goes, ladies and gentlemen. Tough 253.
Can you see why the Tough 253 Escort has been a favourite of mine for so long? Shannon, I haven't seen him out here for a little bit, but it was fantastic to see him bring the noise today.
Well, after all that, it's time to come back for a little bit of mischief.
That's a big bit of mischief.
It's a big bit of mischief. Tristan Lee Magic out of the wildcard shootout, back into the champs, and here he is, the Madness Skid Party's back. Fingers in the air for Tristan Lee Magic in mischief.
Well, well, well. Throwing their hat in the ring to see if they can make the finals tomorrow. Now, I do believe it is 40 cars in the finals.
40.
But, you know, we can split the difference.
Yeah, we'll just keep running until we run out of time.
Yes. Well, unfortunately, our time keeps getting cut short, so that's all right. That's all right.
Felony is
for burnouts.
Up. Mad Nat sticker across the windshield. Looking forward to seeing what Felony can put down here. Not the first time on the pad, but this weekend for Jared Fredrickson.
It is not. But after watching Tristan in front of him, he had some issues when he came out. Remember, he didn't make it out for the wild card. Gerard is going to be like, that was nice. Watch this.
Jared Fredrickson in Felony. He was a wild card in the shootout earlier this weekend. Didn't have a great run, but he is back for the Burnout Championships, and I can see why he was a wild card. Matty, that was outstanding.
Yeah, mate, he does a fantastic job behind the wheel of that Commodore and throwing rubber all over our Burnout pad. I feel like if he bought a block of real estate, he would build right to the very edge of it, because he took that car right to the very edge of every little bit of the Burnout pad right here. as we continue on with our Burnout Championship qualifying here this afternoon. We've just got a little bit more time out on the Rodshot Burnout pad as we try and get through as many cars as possible. Brock Hedlund now coming out in this Holden VY Burnham. That's unfortunate for Brock Hedlund there in the VY Burnham. It just didn't want to get fired up enough, I think, to keep the tyres turning. And we will see him head off the burnout pad. Sometimes you come to the big dance and the car just doesn't want to play games, especially after the Masters. Imagine how much rubber got laid down in just 10 burnouts there in such a short time.
What worries me is the poor bugger. He's been sitting there for hours waiting for his elimination run and then just doesn't play the game. I predict there's going to be some punishment on Skid Row for that car a little bit later on. Sleazy coming up to the line now.
And I don't know, we got double entries once again, so we're going to take a bit of a guess at this one. Thomas Delamont Wells could be in the driver's seat. Of course, LS Converted, make a bit of noise, cheer him on. He wants to be revved up. Well, Sleazy starting something at the rear and putting it out at the front as he drives along there. Unfortunately, a lot of radiator fluid coming out of the front of Sleazy and put a bit of a stop to the end as it heats up in the rear wheel tubs of that VR Commodore Ute. Good to see our safety crew after what is a massive day here. The sun actually came out. It was very, very warm. They are still right on it, doing a fantastic job here at Summit once again. Who wants to see him try and finish the tyres off? Yeah, you do. Silly question. Why do I keep asking?
Go for it, Thomas. Be as sleazy as you can.
Yeah, keep cheering him as he drives off. We love every single one of our Burnout competitors out here. Every single one of them. One of them is part of the Burnout Masters app. Is coming out now. It hasn't been refreshed with this fresh new look he had done just before Summonats. The brand new, what are we going to call it, gold paint job on this one for him?
It's nice and pretty. It's gold. Clickbait is on the start line for us down here.
Told us he made 1,600 horsepower in the dyno in this car as well. It's Mick Hinchy now in clickbait. Ooh, hang on, we're going to be early. We're still sweeping.
McGinty, he's keen. He's keen. He's been around. He's been doing a lot of travel this year. Tried to make the Masters. Didn't quite get there. Can he make an impression on the Burnout Championship? Where is he? He doesn't want to scratch that beautiful paint job, does he?
Would you?
No. No.
There he is.
I hear him.
Clickbait. Fantastic effort down there by Mark Hinchy. Mick Hinchy. Oh, my gosh.
Mick, oh, what are you
it's
doing?
It's
late
day.
In the day. It's been a long day. You might know him. He's a little internet sensation, YouTube and
oh,
stuff.
Oh, he's an
you know.
Influencer.
I watched him taking photos with all his fans the other day.
Selfie,
he's a good bloke.
Selfie.
He is a good bloke. He gets around, does a lot of stuff. Bought that car up from Sydney to do a charity event up here in Canberra as well. Pretty sure he comes from Canberra, so...
I'd say, some of the most generous people on the planet are Burnout people. I love what they do for our community. They're always willing to chip in and help with a fundraiser to 4 Litre coming up
Now. It's normally Guy Clare, but I think his brother Jerry Clare is in the seat here this weekend for Tough 4 Litre. Blown Barra, of course. It's a very
love
unique
concept.
We see a few of them getting around now. And here it goes, Tough 4L. Oh, it's in the smoke. There is so much smoke. Like, I don't think you could tell the difference. That could overcome whatever diff gears they've got in that, because that is making huge amounts of smoke.
Is he still on the pad? I can't see. There he is, on the big screen. Thank goodness for that overhead cam. We do love ourselves a Barra up here.
Are we reversing for a tip in? Oh, no, we're reversing out. Oh, no, over the finish line. Don't go to the Bobcat. Oh, lucky he's got brakes. A moment. A moment there.
Jerry Clare there in Tough 4L. 4 Litre, I'm going to say. Rightio. We've got more Burnout Championship eliminations. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cars. Tiny Towing all the way from Townsville is second last on our list. Great to see Jay Chun tires out of the lawnmower. He said the lawnmower, he won 8 out of 10 laps. And I said, was the last two you lost? And he said, yes, unfortunately, they were the two that counted. Shannon Carson down here right now in this yellow Commodore ute.
Yes, Illicit making his way to the Burnout pad.
It was one of our wildcard cars, Illicit, coming out there and showing us how it's done. Shannon Carson, fantastic effort. Look at the paintwork on this. I don't think that's a wrap. I think that's paint. It's quite beautiful. Hey, it's a flatbed.
Oh, not another one-tonner. You're going to need a moment.
I am. I'm going to need a moment. I do love it. I do love my
flatbed. We don't care. V8 Power turns the tyres and it's here at Summonats.
Ryan Mason. Ooh. That's not a cool noise, mate. That's not
Call
a cool noise.
Rice bubbles. Snap, crackle, pop.
You know what? I have been called on Facebook brutal today. I don't want to say things because, you know, I appreciate every person who put the effort in to build a car, bring it all the way to Summonats and compete. Hats off to you folks. This is fantastic.
I'm not quite sure that's an electrical problem because it didn't sound, but it stopped pretty quick.
It's an If it's an electrical problem, If it's an electrical problem, you fix it with a hammer, don't you?
Don't forget our concerts tonight, ladies and gentlemen. We've got our Super Cruise about to happen at 6 p.m. out there on the oval. They're all lined up and probably leaving any moment now. Our presentation starts at 8 p.m. and Hot Tub Time Machine hits the stage just before 9 o'clock. It's going to be a huge night of entertainment here at the Street Machine Summonats, proudly supported by Rare Spares.
Hey, Maddie, I'm actually going to leave you. Sean's up here to give you a hand. I'm going to go check out the Super Cruise. I will see you tomorrow,
he
though.
He just stands behind me and claps. Is that what you mean by giving me a hand?
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, that's fine.
I'm going to be back here at 9 a.m. tomorrow, though, for the Moto Carna with the Grand Champions.
Ooh, yes.
I want to see the slalom, the go to woe. It's going to be exciting.
Yes, they're Grand Champions. The road to Grand Champion continues tomorrow.
But I will see you at the main stage, Super Cruise, very shortly.
Yeah, don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if it's over yet. We're going to try and push this car off, but our Super Cruise is about to get underway in the main arena. And we'll get that started. And it's always great out there. Plenty of cars getting around, family friendly. And then, of course, we've got our presentations from 8 p.m. where we go through all of our awards and the grass driving events, our Burnout Masters and our John Peterson Burnout Hall of Fame. Who will we be inducting this year? Into that, we'll wait and find out tonight. And then the big entertainment, the man who goes all the way from the 60s or the 50s all the way to now on the DJ decks. He's got the video playing in the background. I don't know if he's got the Hot Tub horns here this weekend. I don't know. He always puts on a show. Wherever he goes, it's Hot Tub Time Machine with the entertainment over there. As it looks like we are still having a bit of a cleanup here. It is edging on 6 p.m. and I am hearing that we have passed our 6 p.m. cutoff here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much to all of our Burnout fans who stayed there in the sun for hours upon hours watching Burnout after Burnout. For everyone who saw the Burnout Masters, what an incredible competition that was. Make sure you download the Summonats app if you want to know what's happening later on tonight and tomorrow. We have been seeing the messages go out on that app and let you know exactly with all the updates, with everything happening around the place. It is our Super Cruise happening out there on the main oval now. And then we will have our presentations from 8 p.m. for some of our awards for the Burnout Masters and our John Peterson Burnout Hall of Fame. And then it's all about entertainment as we party on into the night here at the Street Machine Summonats 36, proudly supported by Rare Spares. If you're going home, well, we're going to see you here from 9 a.m. tomorrow morning for the Road to Grand Champion. We've got some go-to-woe and some slalom to be run before...